curiously enough, I just received an email request a little while ago to send photographs out to some soldiers in Iraq, and they said that Hellraiser is hugely popular amongst the troops out there. Like they weren't in enough hell already.
Well, maybe that's why.
Yeah. Several years ago, there was a daytime talk show in England called Kilroy. And one particular year, for some reason, the fundamentalists were having a go at Halloween as being the soft gateway to eternal damnation, because you begin by dressing up as a witch, and you end up by, you know, sacrificing virgins and biting the heads off chickens and well, yeah, so maybe they're right. And I was there to justify horror films, and I found myself sitting next to a lovely wicker witch that I had a lovely long conversation with. Across the aisle from me was the woman who had, it turned out, been responsible for getting The Exorcist banned in the United Kingdom. So when it came time for me to talk, apart from the fact that Kilroy kept calling me Brian for some reason, I said I was not going to try and justify horror films, because in my opinion they don't need justifying. I said I want to ask this woman, I understand that you were responsible for getting The Exorcist banned. Oh yes, she said, very pleased with herself. I said, well, I wonder why you stopped there. And she said, what do you mean? And I said, well, The Exorcist is a horror film, which belongs to the 20th century, but before that, you have horror fiction in the 20th century, but presumably you would need also to ban the complete works of Edgar Allan Poe, and quite a bit of people like Charles Dickens, and whole chunks of Shakespeare, and the entire works of John Webster have to go, and most of Greek mythology, and most of Hindu mythology, and most of the folk tales of the world. And I'm wondering exactly where you're going to stop, because by the time you've got all this together, this is one hell of a book burning party that you're going to invite us to. And she said, well, I don't want to answer that question. The point I want to make, and bless him, Kilroy jumped right in and said, no, you've been asked a direct question. Do you want to burn all these books? Well, I don't want to get drawn into that. The point I want to make, no, you've been asked a direct question. Do you want, and she kept trying to evade it. He kept coming back, and eventually she said, yes. They are the enemy.
One little thing, you know, we're talking about being in Bible Belt. We probably went to 10, 15 churches to ask them if they'd allow us to shoot the church stand in the church. They wouldn't even talk to us. I mean, forget about it. We had to build a church in order to have this scene that we did. We just finished the movie down in Nashville, the Billy Graham story. We went to the churches to ask them to use the churches, and they threw the doors wide open. And it's just one little part of the Bible will do one thing and it wouldn't do the other thing. When we talk about Hellraiser, they wouldn't even talk to us. We had to build a church in order to do that same.
Mike, given we were blowing the windows out of the damn thing and blowing up the altar, is probably just as well we didn't use a real church.
Yeah, that probably helped.
We got time for a couple more questions. Who's next?
This is kind of a small question, but I just wanted to know, like, what current projects any of you are kind of working on. I noticed that Ashley Lawrence is into painting and art right now, so I was just kind of curious about it.
I did a movie earlier this year, which hopefully will come out next year. Just a very small cameo role in Clive's Book of Blood, which is the first of, I think, six or seven movies which he's planning to make over the next three or four years.
Midnight Meat Train.
Oh yeah, of course, Midnight Meat Train was the first. I don't know if you've seen it, I haven't seen it yet, but I hear good things about it. So Book of the Blood is the second story, but it's the opening story of the Books of Blood, so.
It's the first and last story, I think, isn't it?
Yeah, he's taken the very first story of the short stories of the Books of Blood and the very last one and put them together to make this project. And it's interesting, Clive saw the final cut of it a few weeks ago, so I'm looking forward to talking to him and finding out what it's going to be like. I think they're all going to be very different. All of the stories have very different themes. I assume Midnight Meat Train is quite intense, whereas Book of Blood is more of a, is going back to the love story kind of themes.
And they're planning to do In the Hills, the Cities as an anime, kind of manga style, because obviously you struggle to make that with real actors.
Yes, I'm painting and I'm working and auditioning for some cool things and waiting to hear about one in particular that I really want, but I can't know yet. My first novel is being, which is about a serial killer, is being considered by three different publishers at the moment. And I'm now working on my second novel, which is a vampire crime novel.
I have an even smaller cameo role in the same film that Simon was talking about, non-speaking, playing a character who's a bit like Aleister Crowley. A production company that I'm part of, I'm selling these at my table. It was an idea that kind of grew out of doing the audiobook of Mr. Begone, Clive's last novel. So it's kind of an audio-visual audiobook, if you like. So it's H.P. Lovecraft's story, The Outsider. I'm narrating it. I was filmed in green screen, so then I could be moved around as an element, and we combined it with illustration and a little bit of CG animation. It's under the banner of Doug Bradley's Spine Chillers, and we're working on the second of them right now. At least I'm not, people back in England are, while I'm gallivanting around America, which is The Telltale Heart. We've also been doing some straight audio recording, and which we'd like to kind of expand and do a whole raft of classic horror stories. If the series takes off, and that largely depends on you lovely people putting your hands in your pockets and buying it so we actually make money out of it, I'd love to expand it, and I'd love to do things like, you know, go to people like Robert Englund and say, what's your favorite short horror story? Would you like to go and stand in front of a green screen in LA for half a day and we'll film it and do it? Or ask Jeffrey Combs to do the Reanimator stories. We'll see what happens. But that's it. I've got a couple of movies coming up in the new year in England. So still trying to keep busy.
You know, we work with a gentleman named Larry Bortoff. He produces films, and we've done about seven films for him. We cast these films for him. One of them was Hellraiser 3, the other was Children of the Corn, and other films. The one we just did down in Nashville was for him. And we're waiting on the call now. We're going to cast a movie in Israel. We don't know much about it, but we're going to Israel as soon as we get the call, and that could be later on this year. So that's our next project. We're going to cast a movie in Israel. How you do that, I'm not sure, but I'm going.
Final question. Who's it going to? Right there in the front.
This actually isn't a question, more like a comment towards Ashley. I'm sure I'm going to speak for everybody in this room. I just had one word, and it's wow.
What else could you say? Ladies and gentlemen, it's here for the Hellraiser cast.